deep diving under pressure. As far back as ancient Greek and Roman times, humans have always been fascinated with diving deep below the ocean surface. Whether searching for food, treasures, or simply driven by curiosity, the challenge of diving down deeper and deeper has been one of a constant battle with a mighty force: water pressure. The deeper we go underwater, the greater the water pressure upon our lungs, and the more dangerous it becomes. Let's take a look at how far down we can go, with and without equipment. You may be surprised. But first, we need to understand how water pressure works. On land, at sea level, the air pressure that surrounds us pushes down at about 6.5 kilograms per square inch, otherwise known as one atmosphere. Why don't we feel it? Because the fluids in our body are pushing back with roughly the same force. So far, so good. However, it's a whole different ballgame when we start diving underwater. Water pressure increases fast and seriously restricts us going deeper. When we go even a few meters underwater, we're quickly aware of pressure changes. We can feel our eardrums getting tighter, which is due to the force of water on our bodies. For every 10 meters we go down, the pressure increases by the same 6.5 kilograms, or one atmosphere. How does this affect us? Well, the more pressure is applied, the more our lungs contract. So by diving just 10 meters underwater, now means 2 atmospheres of pressure are applied. Our lungs contract to half their size. Despite this, humans can continue to keep diving below 10 meters as our bodies default to an underwater physiological change. We automatically go into a process called bradycardia, where our heart rate slows by as much as 30%, which reduces the amount of oxygen we use. The most experienced deep divers can slow their heart rates to an incredible 15 beats per minute. That's slower than someone in a coma. However, the further we go down, the less chance we have of our bodies being able to push back against the water pressure. When we can no longer push back against the water pressure, our soft tissue systems would be crushed and our lungs would collapse, killing us immediately. While there is no clear limit as to how far a human can dive down without apparatus, it's generally agreed that anything deeper than 30 to 40 meters would be extremely dangerous. At that level, our bodies are being exposed to around 4 atmospheres of pressure, 4 times what we are used to on land. The physicist Robert Boyle showed that the volume of a gas at constant temperature varies inversely with the pressure exerted on it. Put simply, the amount of gas or oxygen in the human body decreases with the amount of water pressure it's under. Not surprisingly, many people have died going beyond their limits while deep diving without equipment, making it a seriously hazardous sport. With the aid of weighted sleds, though, deep divers have been able to surpass the 30 to 40 meter mark and reach amazing depths in a matter of minutes. In 2007, Austrian Herbert Nitsch set a world deep diving record by plummeting 214 meters into the Mediterranean Sea. He used a specially made inflated balloon to help rocket him back to the water's surface safely. At this deep level, the human lungs would deflate from a regular melon size to that of a tennis ball. But how far down can we go with the aid of equipment, or even diving craft? Scuba divers can go deeper, but they too are restricted. A misconception is that scuba divers are equipped with tanks of air. However, their tanks are actually a mix of gases. This is normal. You may be surprised to learn that the air we breathe in every day is actually about 21% oxygen and 79% nitrogen. Scuba divers use the same mix, however, the deeper we dive down, the more nitrogen we absorb into our bloodstreams. This can be dangerous, as excessive nitrogen will impair the body's nervous system, causing a drunken-like state called nitrogen narcosis. This can lead to brain failure and death. As a result, scuba divers use compressed air, which has the same pressure as that below sea level. Another popular option is using nitrox, which has enriched air at a higher level of oxygen and lower level of nitrogen, allowing divers to stay underwater deeper and longer. In 2014, Egyptian Ahmed Gabir set a world record for the deepest scuba dive with a 332-meter dive in the Red Sea. Apart from using the standard compressed air of oxygen and nitrogen, he also used helium, which is critical in reducing the effects of nitrogen narcosis. Gabir's descent only took a few minutes, but going back up took a staggering 14 hours to complete. That's right, he was underwater for just under 15 hours. All scuba divers have to ascend slowly in order for them to be able to decompress the nitrogen from their tissues. If they do it carefully, the nitrogen will leave their body as they breathe out. However, if they ascend too quickly, the nitrogen will form bubbles in the body's tissues, which can have some serious repercussions, such as paralysis and nerve damage. This is known as decompression sickness, or the bends. In the worst cases, it can result in brain damage and death. Several fatalities have been recorded when divers attempted to reach the hallowed 300-meter mark. Their lungs either collapsed due to the extreme pressure, or they ascended too quickly, resulting in brain failure. Advancements in technology have enabled divers to reach even greater depths. Saturation diving has been used for scientific research and commercial purposes. Divers are first saturated with suitable diving gases such as helium and nitrox at the same pressure of the surrounding water. This can take up to several days just to fully prepare. The divers stay in the saturated state for the duration of their work, which can last for days or longer. They remain in special chambers which maintain the desired pressure rate. Usually, decompression from deep dives can take as long as 24 hours. However, if the divers spend the whole time saturated in chambers, they only need decompression at the end of their work. This saves them going out of the water, decompressing, and going back in. A huge time saver. In 1998, a team of COMEX divers carried out pipeline connection exercises at a record depth of 534 meters. The divers experienced pressures of over 50 times that of atmospheric pressure on the surface. However, if you want to go really deep, in fact as deep as possible, then there can only be one destination, the Mariana Trench. The Mariana Trench is the world's deepest oceanic trench. It's located in the western Pacific Ocean, just south of Guam. Its deepest known point is almost 11,000 meters below sea level. If you took Mount Everest and placed it down at that level, the peak still wouldn't break the water's surface. Understandably, the Mariana Trench has been a source of fascination for scientific and geological missions. Four manned descents have been achieved. The first took place in 1960, when a two-man team recorded a 10,916-meter dive to the bottom. In 2012, movie director James Cameron became the first solo diver to reach the deepest point below the Earth's surface, but obviously protected by his vessel, the Deep Sea Challenger, and in it he was able to dive to 10,908 meters. Cameron is the only human being to have gone solo to the Earth's deepest point and returned. "It was bleak," he said. "It looked like the moon. I didn't see a fish. I didn't see anything that looked alive to me, other than a few shrimp-like amphipods in the water." Quite fitting from the man who directed sci-fi classics such as Aliens and Avatar. The Western Pacific Ocean remains the focus of many deep-diving enthusiasts. With billionaires such as Richard Branson and Elon Musk expressing interest in deep-sea exploration, the possibilities for the future are limitless. Scuba diving participation has been increasing worldwide, year by year. More and more people want to go deep, and deeper.